What is going on, everyone? This is Matthew with the Pentagraphics channel, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about power racks, but not just any old power rack. Today, we're going to be talking about the one and only, the Mega Monster Power Rack. That's right, this thing right here that I'm sitting inside of. You've seen it on Instagram, you've read about it in the newspaper, and today you're going to see it here officially on the YouTube channel. So buckle up, you're going to be in for a bumpy yet smooth, comfortable ride. So if this sounds interesting to you, you're not gonna wanna go anywhere. Now, as always, if you're new to the channel, welcome, glad to have you. Consider subscribing if you like this kind of content, as I plan on making videos just like this weekly. Also, you may wanna consider following me on Instagram, because I do post on there quite a bit more frequently than I do on here. I mean, it's just easier. Yeah. Also, I just hit 1,000 subscribers thanks to all y'all. I appreciate the heck out of it. I've got a 1,000 subscriber video plan that I think is gonna be really fun for everyone involved, maybe, I don't know. But that's gonna happen this weekend, so stay tuned for that. So with all that being said, let's jump into this video. I know y'all have so many questions, such as what the heck is a Mega Monster Power Rack? Where did he get this thing from? How did this guy get so handsome? And just bear with me, I will get to all of your questions in good time. Mega Monster Power Rack, what is it? It's everything you want and nothing you need. Basically, it's the equivalent of an RM-6 and an RM-3 smashed together. What I mean by that is I've got an RM-6 and I extended the front 30 inches. So now I've got a 24-inch section in the rear, a 43-inch working section, obviously, and then now I've got a 30-inch working section off the front of that. So it's a Mega Monster Rack. What else would you call it? Now, I'm not gonna lie, this is probably the best thing I've ever done in my life. And keeping in mind, I've gotten married and had kids. So let that sink in. I mean, I'm pretty sure my priorities are all out of whack. If you're anything like me, you're probably asking yourself, why did I even do this? And I'm gonna tell you exactly why. For me, honestly, it's as simple as I just wanted the ability to set up two stations within my rack without ever having to leave my rack and to work on the outside. I know there are a lot of people that like half rack setups, have no problems working off the front of a rack, put the safety spotter arms in place. Yes, it works, but mentally, I'd prefer to work on the inside of a rack. That's essentially why I bought a power rack. I like the cage system. I like the mental security that it provides, the comfort. It's like a baby blanket for me when I'm lifting. Anyways, in this current configuration, I can basically set up something like bench press or use my trolley arms in the main portion of the rack. And then the next additional frontal section, I can set up something like an incline press or a military press without ever having to leave the comfort of the inside of the rack. I never have to work on the outside. Now, another reason that I wanted to build this monster of a setup is that I wanted the ability to leave all of my Slinger accessories attached to the rack at all times, such as my lap pull-down seat, my plate load attachment, my solo pulley. When I had it mounted to the RM6, it was kind of a problem having to move it around and I didn't like it. Basically, the issue that I kept running into is the fact that when using the plate load attachment, I couldn't use my flip down safeties. They always either wanted to share the same holes or it just wouldn't allow me to drop the flip downs exactly as to where I needed to be. I was always having to move something or it just got annoying. Now, I know, before you say anything, I know exactly what you're thinking. Matthew, come on. Why are you not using that lever arm setup that you've shown so many times in videos in the past? And I really don't have a good answer for you, except for I'm lazy. I'm not saying I'm lazy in life or anything, but when it comes to working out, I know it's hard to believe, judging by my body and whatnot. I mean, it's glorious. I'm kind of one of those that I'm hit or miss and I'm skipping around. There's no consistency, and that's my own fault. I will change that eventually. But I mean, it is what it is right now. Here's the deal. When it comes to an exercise that I want to do, I want it to be quick and easy setup. And if it's not, then I usually skip out on it. That's kind of the issue that I ran into with the lat pull down, the Slinger. It wasn't always set up and it was a pain to put on, take off yet. And so I just skipped out on it. The lever arm lat pull down setup, as easy as it is to set that up, I mean, it's just dropping the arm down in position, adding the shackle, the two weight horns. It's not a big deal, but it does require some time to do so. And most of the time when I'm working out, I feel like I'm always in a pinch or a crunch for time, especially nowadays. And it's just, I wanted to get away from having to set anything up at all, just push everything forward, add it to the rack. It's its own entity. And now I've got the weights on there and it's always good to go. Now, before we leave the topic of the Slinger, one more little tidbit for y'all, a suggestion, if you will. When it comes to using the Slinger, the biggest annoyance for me is the fact that when I want to do a weight change, I've got to take whatever attachment that I'm hanging on to off. That takes the tension off the cable. Then I can undo the carabiner, put my weight plates on, whatever. My suggestion, or what I did, is I took a Matador hanger and I mounted that to the front of the rack. So now, when I want to take the tension off the cable to do the weight changes, I'll just hang my attachment up there. And it works great. I highly suggest maybe looking into this if you've got the same problem. Granted, I know there are probably cheaper solutions. You can probably buy like S-hooks and hook them in there. But this Matador hanger looks legit. It looks like it was designed for this, and also to hang a Matador. So, but anyways, little tidbit for you. If you like it, keep it. If not, I didn't charge you for it. So now that I have answered the why, let's answer the how, such as how did you even build this thing, Matthew? And that is a wonderful question. I am glad you asked. Basically, I just contacted Rogue, told them what I needed, got a custom quote from them, and I ordered it. Simple as that. Now, my particular setup obviously consists of monster parts. I've got two 90-inch uprights, I've got two 30-inch bottom cross members, and then two 30-inch top cross members, all in the Rogue Red color. And then, of course, I went locally and bought myself some hardware, the nuts, the bolts, the lock washers. I highly suggest you do the same thing if you're able to. If you're not, I'm sure Rogue would be glad to sell you this stuff. Hopefully it's not gonna be an arm and a leg. I just know if you get it locally, you're gonna save yourself on the shipping. Again, these are my specific choices. Obviously, I wanted Rogue Red because my rack was already red. I wanted the 30-inch depth because I didn't want to go another 43 inches out. And I thought that 24 would be a little too shallow because I wanted to use my safety spotter arms. 30 inches made the most sense to me. To each their own. And now that I've answered the how, let's answer the when, such as when can I take a tour of this thing? And you, my friends, are in luck because we're about to take the tour right now. So taking a step back and absorbing it all in, you're going to notice several things right off the bat. Now, one thing you may have noticed is the fact that I have moved my Rogue nameplate to the rear of the rack. To me, it just makes the most sense because now that I've gained so much depth, I have to push this rack as far back to the wall as possible. And so I had to take my crown pull-up bar that was previously mounted to the rear of the rack facing the wall, take it off, move it to the inside of the rack, push the rack back to the wall, and then I moved the nameplate towards the back. Trust me, it was the best thing for me to do. And like I said, now that the crown pull-up bar isn't on the rear, I've moved it to the inside of the rack, which actually works phenomenally. I know I had some people ask me, you know, dimensionally, will it fit inside the rack? The slanted, widest grips, are they gonna clear the cross members? And I'm here to answer, yes, it does. You can do everything on the crown pull-up bar that you could do before. If it's mounted on the front, the rear, inside, makes no difference. I can't really say too much more about it other than I personally love it. Also, another thing that I gained by moving my nameplate from the center of the rack to the rear is the fact that my trolley arms can now slide up even further on the uprights. No longer do they hit the bottom of the nameplate because it was actually hanging down lower than the cross member I've got up there now. So not that I really needed that height, but now I've got that extra height and I'll take it. Now, speaking of the trolleys, as you can see here, I've got the Rogue Monster LT1 50 cal trolley and lever arm kit installed on the inside of my rack, which means I went with the shorter arms. If you are new to the channel, if you haven't seen any of my previous videos, I highly implore you go back and watch some of those if this is of interest to you, because I actually have got a video explaining why I went with the shorter over the longer, and then I show multiple exercises you can do with the shorter that maybe people think you can't do and you have to get the longer ones. Again, to each their own. If you want to get the longer ones and mount them on the outside of the rack, go for it. I'm not going to stop you because I don't know where you live. So another upgrade that I made to the rack that was pretty simple and inexpensive is I ordered a top cross member to connect what was formerly the previous front uprights. There was nothing connecting them because I moved the pull-up bar that was there to now the front of the rack, which left those open. I mean, it was screaming to have something connected. So I bought a top cross member from the Rogue website. Now it gains me the ability to connect like shackles or whatever to it. I can basically take advantage of the holes. Again, it was a pretty cheap upgrade. I had to buy the hardware, of course, but I think it was worth it to do it. And it also looks cool and it provides more stability. Not that the rack needs anymore, but why not do that? Moving on from the functionality aspects, what I can do with this thing, let's talk about the elephant in the room, which is the rack itself. I mean, this thing is huge. Huge! Too much. Obviously, this thing is now 8 uprights instead of 6. It went from 76 inches deep to 109. Wow. I honestly don't think I could go back to an RM6 now that I've created this beast of a rack. I love it. Alrighty, everyone, that is all I've got for y'all. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. And if you did, hit that like button. Show me some love. If that's a saying, love me. What? That's even weirder. Hit that like button. Subscribe. Follow me on Instagram. All that good stuff. And this weekend, 1,000 subscriber video. It's happening. I hope to see you there. I'm not actually going to see you, but you're going to see me. And I'm going to know you see me because I'm going to feel it. Right here in my chest. Y'all have a good day. Thanks again for watching. Take it easy. But yeah, we're gonna be talking about this thing right here, the Mega Monster Power Rack. Bah! That really hurt.